I'm from Newcastle upon Tyne, which is a small working class town in the northeast of England.
Any opportunity I get to come back, I'll be straight home. This region's very important to me. I'm very much a product of the northeast.
Well, here we are back home. About to surprise my mum.
It's gonna be weird.
Surprise her. Hello, mother.
Oh,
how you doing?
I'm fine, son. Older than if I've seen you. Are you all right, son?
Why?
Oh, it's lovely to see you. Welcome home, son.
It's quite a small town, but it's definitely home for me.
It's just a huge piece of modern art, but it's got a certain character. I like it. It's certainly an iconic symbol of the northeast. It only means a lot to me, personally. I'd often come up here, you know, just to take 5 minutes from the world and take it all in. She's kind of like a guardian angel to the Newcastle area.
It's famous for a lot of things, mainly our beer and also our football team.
Oh, in St James's Park, where else? The home of Newcastle United Football Club, the greatest football team on the face of earth.
And the soccer team especially is something I'm very passionate about.
From walking, you could kick a football.
Being from England, growing up, everybody plays football.
Yeah, outside of, you know, being a WWE wrestler, the backup dream was always to play for Newcastle United.
Most little Geordie lads want to be a footballer, but Ben never did. He wanted to be a wrestler.
Well, I did want to be a footballer for a little bit.
Not for
but
very
wrestling
long.
Was always,
and then
always
it was
the
wrestling.
Priority.
He wanted to be a wrestler. He wanted to be a wrestler. Nothing else.
And that was only helped along by the fact that my mum and my dad, they didn't want me watching wrestling.
Originally, I wasn't really allowed to watch it, so I had to sneak to my auntie's house.
Must have been 7 or 8 years old, and she was a fan of WWE, and she was watching it, and I'd never seen it before. As soon as I saw it, my breath was taken away.
I was certainly enamoured.
So that kind of became the thing that I couldn't do, which became the thing I wanted to do. I always knew, I was determined that I was going to give it my best shot and I was going to make it work.
This is where it all began, St Joseph's Hall. It's pretty much the only wrestling school in the area. I was 18 years old, I was looking to train to become a sports entertainer, professional wrestler, and this was the place locally that you could do it.
I remember being spoken to many a time by my family, my mom, my grandmother, and they tell me to stop being stupid, Ben. You're from Newcastle. Nobody from Newcastle becomes a wrestler. Find a real job.
You know, I didn't give him much support, but he went on. He was very determined, and I eat my words now.
I tried to develop my high-flying moves, my high-flying techniques. I started getting noticed because of the moves that I do. It was unique and it hadn't been seen in Britain before. When I step through the ropes, I'm just in my element. That's when I really become myself. That's when I'm at the most peace with myself, you know, that I really feel that's my zone.
So, yeah, there's lots of history to this building as far as my career is concerned. I'll wear this tonight when I make my entrance.
Yeah, you know, I used to ride my bike to this arena and never in a million years did I expect to be, you know, walking out as a WWE superstar in the Metro Radio Arena in Newcastle. I can feel goosebumps right now just thinking about it.
The reaction was incredible, couldn't ask for any more, but everything I hoped it would be, and then some. I can't believe this is what I do for a living, and I'm very fortunate.
Sometimes I feel like I'm dreaming and I'll wake up. I've done a lot of travelling, but Newcastle is always my home and always will be.
The best day of my life.